we are going to learn about organic chemistry. Now, organic chemistry is a study of organic compounds. However, just as we have organic compounds, there are inorganic compounds too. So, per the syllabus of high school integrated science, we are supposed to know the definitions for organic compounds, inorganic compounds, and group some examples under both these categories. Okay. So, the first kind is organic compounds. Organic compounds. So what then is organic compounds? Now you're a first time learner of organic chemistry. Don't be afraid at all because it's not difficult at all, okay? So organic compounds is when you have a compound and in the compound you have at least a carbon and a hydrogen bond. So let me define it. An organic compound is a compound with at least one carbon hydrogen bond. So you've all learned about compounds at first grade, I think grade 9, from grade 9, grade 10, grade 12, okay? So we know what a compound is. A compound is a chemical combination of two or more elements. So when you have elements being grouped together, is that okay? That is a compound. Chemically, such that it cannot be broken further into simpler substances using any other physical means. You can only use breaking of bonds to break them apart. Is that okay? So you have a compound such that the compound contains a carbon and a hydrogen bond. So I'll give you some examples and you consider. Now I'm talking about carbon and a hydrogen bond. So carbon and a hydrogen bond. So in any compound at all, if you see at least one of these in the compound, in the structure, it means that whole structure becomes organic compound. Now, this is the same as this. If I write it this way, this one is called structural formula. If I write it this way, it's called condensed formula. When you're condensed milk, this is condensed formula. Okay, it's the same thing. And any compound BR which contains this carbon, this is called a bond. This dash is called a bond in chemistry. Okay, so any compound that contains at least one of this or that is said to be an organic compound. If that compound do not contain this or that, then means that compound is an inorganic compound. So we have organic compounds and we have inorganic compounds. So for inorganic compounds, they do not contain carbon hydrogen bond. Is that okay? So let me give you the first example of an organic compound. So okay, so don't be afraid about this structure. And you don't need to know how to draw this structure, it is above your level. But here, I just want you to identify if you can be able to see carbon-hydrogen bond, okay? So, this whole molecule or compound, so this is a compound, this whole compound is called glycine. You don't need to know the name of the compound, it's not necessary. Now, glycine is an amino acid. In your body, you've heard that we have something called amino acids, right? These amino acids are being put together to form a long compound or chain, and we call that one as proteins. So before you can form a protein, you need to combine amino acids. So one example of amino acid is glycine, and this is the structure of glycine. Now I want to know whether glycine is an organic compound or inorganic compound, okay? So when you come here you have OH bond, so O is bonding to H. If I want to write the structural formula, I'll write it like this. If I want to write the condensed formula, I'll write it like this, okay? I won't bring any dash here. So this is OH, and this is not a CH bond. When you come here, you have CO bond. This is not a CH bond. When you come, you have CO bond. This is not a CH bond. When you come, you have C, this C bonded to this C. You have C bonding to this C. This is not a CH bond. But over here, you've got C bonding to H. And why is to have C bonding to H? So we have one CH here, and you have another CH here. So because of this, because we have one or more of the CH bond here, remember that any organic compound should bear a CH bond. So because of this structure has got a CH bond, it means this whole compound is said to be an organic compound. So glycine, which is an amino acid, is an organic compound. And in the body, you have a whole lot of organic compounds in the body. So this is one example of organic compound. Now let's consider the structure too. Now this is another example, okay? We call this one ethanol. Ethanol. Normally, when you're making a sanitizer, one example, one requirement is needed an ethanol. Or the other one, which is isopropyl alcohol. We will talk about functional groups, so don't worry. So this one, ethanol, is that okay? When you come here, you have OH bond, no. You have a CH bond, yes. You have another CH bond, yes. You have a CH bond, yes. You have another CH bond, yes. Another CH bond, yes. So because we have at least one CH bond, it makes the whole compound to be organic compound. So this is one example of organic compound. Now let's consider another example again. Let's consider water. H2O. H2O, the structure is this. Or you can write it like this. If you are an integrated science student, just write it this way, it's okay. If you're an elective chemistry student, you should know the structure is this. But I'm not talking about how the shape is like, okay? The shape is not important here. So let's consider here. We know that water has got a bent shape because of the lone pair system on the oxygen. But don't be worried about that. Let's go by this one. So H2 means the H's are 2 and 1 oxygen. So the 1 oxygen will rather be at the center. So we have one oxygen here and two hydrogens here, okay? Now, we're going to consider this and that. This is an OH bond, OH. And so, there's another OH bond here. So for water, you don't have a CH bond in there. You only have OH bond, another OH bond. So because of that, water is inorganic. So sometimes our parents will say that, oh, everything natural is organic. It is never true. You know, water is natural. Okay. But here, because it lacks a CH bond, it's never considered that to be an organic compound. Is that okay? Let's also consider this compound too. This is CO2. You see, CO2, you have carbon. If you consider the condensed formula, you have carbon, but you don't have any oxygen, hydrogen here. So you can't have a CH bond here. So using the condensed formula, there is no H appearing here. So you can say that CO2 is an inorganic compound. Carbon dioxide is an inorganic compound. If you write it to be the structural formula, so there is no hydrogen here. So CO2 is an inorganic compound. Is that okay? So now we know what an organic compound is. We know what inorganic compounds are. And almost everything we eat is organic. Almost all the components of the body is organic. Talking about the proteins, talking about the nucleic acids, talking about the metabolites and other stuff. But okay, so the next time we move on to functional group chemistry. Okay, we have got several functional groups. Okay, so let me review to some of the functional groups. But seriously, you will study them into details. Okay. And per the syllables, we are supposed to study every functional group, its uses, properties, and then some kind of small naming and then the other stuff. Okay? So we've got what we call functional groups. So in chemistry or under organic compounds, we have something we call functional groups. So just as we have families, okay, organic compounds, we have classification. So functional groups is just a classification of organic compounds, okay? So it's a classification of organic compounds. So we human beings, we have families, is that okay? And for us, every family has got its unique family name or surname, okay? So for me, our family surname or family name is Ofosu. And everybody in that goddamn family is called Ofosu, you feel me? So everybody has got a family name. Apart from that, families have their personality traits that's able to identify whether you're coming from this family. Maybe their facial chemistry, the way they talk and all that stuff. So organic compounds too, they've got families. And then these families that we call functional groups. So we can talk about the first family, which is alkenes. The next family is alkenes. The next family is alkynes. You talk about them, don't be worried. And you didn't cry. Make sure you want more as a good thing. The next one is called carboxylic acids. You also call them alkanoic acids. Now, people also call the alkenes olefins. And people call the carboxylic acids alkanoic acid. People also call alcohols as alkanols. People also call esters. Esters as alkanes. And then the last one will be fats and oil. Okay, so per your syllabus, you'll be studying about seven classification of organic compounds. We have the first functional group, which is called alkenes. The second functional group called alkenes. Say alkenes. We're the same as olefins, okay? We have the alkynes, so alkenes, alkenes, alkynes. We have the carboxylic acids or the alkanoic acids. We have the alcohols or the alkanols. We have the esters or the alkanes. Note the spelling. Don't go and spell the esters like this. Don't go ahead. It's not like this, okay? It's this, esters. So some people call the esters alkanes and then the fats and oils, okay? So in our next lecture or in the next tutorial section, we'll be talking about the properties and uses of alkanes, the properties and uses of alkenes, the properties and uses of alkynes, carboxylic acids, alcohols, esters, fats and oil. And after that, we'll look at some of the reactions of esters, esterification, reaction, neutralization, reaction, which is all very, very simple. Now, make sure to one more thing. You won't go into much into details right after that. Maybe I'll get the chemistry, elective chemistry students somewhere and then give them that name, because in elective chemistry you're supposed to know the name, but in organic integrated science you're not supposed to know to all that much, at least first four members of every functional group. So if you talk about alkanes, the first member of alkane is called methane. The second member is called ethane, the third member is called propane, and then we have butane. So at least you, as integrated science students, you learn the naming from ethane to butane. It's okay for us, okay? When it comes to the alkenes, we have the methanes, we have the ethanes, we have the propenes, we have the butenes. When it comes to the alkynes, we have the methane, we have the ethane, we have the propane, and we have the butane. When it comes to the carboxylic acids, you have the alcohols, you have the methanol, we have the ethanol, propanol, and so on and so forth. Okay, so until now, let's meet another time. Okay, so I'll drop another question on the WhatsApp page. Please, it's about identification of organic compounds and inorganic compounds. So, until me next time, bye bye.